everybody. Welcome back to Taz's Wig Closet at Wig Studio One, where I can try it before you buy it. This is a wig review of the brand new Alva Style by Noriko in the color Sugar Cane R. You won't want to miss all these details coming up. So Alva is a short to mid-length straight bob style with a straight across bang. I purchased this style with my own funds from Wig Studio One. Be sure to expand the description box below where you will find a link to the product where you can check out the details and pricing. If you have any questions about this style or any other, they're always ready to help you if you email support@wigstudioone.com. So among the three new styles by Noriko that came out for fall 2020, Alva is one that I wasn't sure about. I was sort of on the fence about it. I know a lot of you have been asking if I was going to make this review, and initially I said I wasn't. And I was really waiting for a few reviews to come out to see if I wanted to invest in this style for myself. I decided to go ahead and purchase it based on a few reviews that I seen that looked really lovely. And I really do love this style. I think it's a great value in that brand new line. So we're gonna drill down in the details of the style very quickly here. And I wanna let you know, we're gonna go into quite a bit of depth on these bangs. I think they're really, really well done. So let's talk about this color though first, get that out of the way, the Sugar Cane R. Now I've seen some differences in the most recent versions of Sugar Cane R than I have in the past. And I'm wondering if they even changed the official description of the color. It's a 50-50 blend of some platinum and some strawberry blonde. Now the strawberry in this is more on the cool spectrum. So it's not a cool or ashy tone by any means, but the strawberry isn't bright orange. It has more of a toned down look. So you've got a strawberry blonde mixed in there with some of those finer platinum highlights, just a nice 50-50 blend. And then what you'll see in there as well is some light auburn. And that light auburn can appear a little chunky in areas. And that light auburn is what I think really warms this up. So it is just that neutral, warm overall appearance on this color. The platinum neutralizes a little bit. Without the platinum, this would just appear to be more of a light auburn all around. Now that is on a medium brown root. And I think they did that root transition beautifully on this color. So now for the wig style. So you know how you can put on a wig and you can immediately think of something that it reminds you of? I put this on and just the way the bangs are structured, it reminded me of one of Suzanne Summers' haircuts. I think she's a beautiful woman and really, really rocks those bangs. So that bang length is about 4 inches. It runs straight across. Depending on where you're positioning your wig, that should strike you right around the eyebrow area. And then in the back, overall length is about 12 inches from the top of the crown to the tip of the hair in the back. It's more of a blunt cut, meaning there's just not many layers going on here. And that gives it that straight, almost sleek appearance. Now it's not without texture on the ends. As you will see, some of that layering does swoop in and really frame the face nicely. This whole picture is just done to perfection, the layering around the face. So this weighs just under 4 ounces and it features Noriko's traditional machine-made style cap. There's no lace or no monofilament. I have to say that this was brilliant. A style like this does not need lace or monofilament to look amazing. And that helps keep the price point down, make it more affordable for those that really enjoy this kind of style. So your bang area and all of these layers really obscure that wig line from the front. You're absolutely beautiful at the front, very natural looking. And a monofilament top does add some realism from the front, especially where you part it. But because this is a little more thickly threaded on top, I imagine you probably couldn't see down to a monotop anyway. It might be a waste on a style like this. Noriko has really perfected this kind of cap. I've said this for a long time, that I can never go wrong with Noriko's traditional caps. Sometimes their lace fronts can be hit and miss, but they always nail their traditional caps. The caps are built very sturdy and they're very well obscured. They have great coverage. Depending on your circumference and measurements, they can run a little bit petite. On this particular one, I'm a 21 1/4 inch circumference. I did cinch it in just a tad to accommodate that circumference, and it fits me beautifully all the way around. So I imagine it's really quite average right out of the box. So I really want to hone in on this beautiful bang area. This bang is done so well, and I try to figure out what makes it so flattering. So there's a few things. So first of all, it's a nice wispy texture. There's not a thick straight across bang here. So it's a nice wispy texture. It has a dirty style cut, just meaning it's a little bit notch cut there at the ends. It looks completely realistic, covers up that wig line very well. Now it appears to be a little bit of an undercut bang. And what I mean by that is if you pull back these layers, that bang length stretches all the way back to this edge of the cap on both sides. That means you're going to get amazing coverage if you pull it back like this. You can expose the whole bang. But what they did was they made some of those side layers kind of overlap that bang, makes it appear a little bit undercut, and it just gives that really cute fringe effect around the eyes. You see why this is so flattering? There's no thinning that's going to be needed on these bangs. I feel like the length is just right, despite my measurement is petite from hairline to chin. It has a little bit of curvature to them inward. It's just done to perfection. It's going to look amazing, and I can't wait to start styling to show them off. The other thing about this style that's super flattering is the fact that it's not overly dense. It's a nice average density featuring extremely baby fine dry fibers. When I say dry, I just mean baby fine and separated, feathery almost. It moves like human hair. It has a nice human hair like sheen to it, of nice healthy hair. It's not shiny, but Noriko fibers do. They have this kind of sheen to them. It looks incredibly natural, like healthy human hair. And I also think that the length is very flattering. It's going to strike most people probably just above the shoulder. On me, it kind of drags the shoulder a little bit there, but it has a slight undercurve to it, like a traditional bob style. It's not an angled style. It's pretty much the same length all the way around. And it's marvelous the way they did this permatease. You've got the permatease on the top. The permatease will run from the tip of the cap here all the way to the crown. You've got that little bit of a bump it there. It stretches down to about here, and then it tapers off. So the permatease is actually very light there at the ear tab, lighter at the back, and virtually none at the nape. So like I like to say, it's all the right amounts in all the right places to support the style. So where you're getting a little bit of lift is here, where you want it, and not right here on the sides to make it look helmet-like. You know, the last thing you want is a bob style cut of this length to look like a mushroom head. So this definitely does not. I mean, can you pinch in some volume and lift? Yes, you can. Most Norikos are very conducive to that. I think you can draw out your best look. So just to recap what I think is super remarkable about this that made me fall in love with this style when I'm not real crazy about bangs and straight bobs is the bang area. Exquisitely done. Very flattering, I would imagine, for all face shapes. And then the fact that it has this light, feathery, wispy style texture. Here's an inside look at the cap for Noriko's Alva. There's that closed top hiding the wefts and the permatees. And then you have this nice velvet strip there at the very front, as well as a hidden weft for good coverage. The seams are done extremely well on this cap. Lots of fiber spliced into a closed ear tab. Very thoughtfully done. Just a standard velvet style nape with bra strap type adjusters, lots of wefting, and an average amount of stretch. So Alva arrived at my doorstep just last night. I put it on, I shook it out, and it's ready to go. I haven't used any product or any kind of styling, nothing to mold or sculpt this style. This is literally what you're gonna see right out of the box with a nice good shake. Now, the more you get in there and kind of work with the fibers, the more you're gonna flesh out the style and bring it to life. Let's try here with glasses real quick. All right, these are the Beatrix glasses, readers by readers.com. They're a bit funky, aren't they? They sent these to me last year. I just love readers.com for the variety. So you can just really tap into any of those styles to help match your personality, your mood, and occasion. Just gorgeous. They fit beautifully between the ear and the ear tab. As I mentioned, that permatease kind of tapers off as you move closer to the ear tab. First of all, I think it would look amazing too with some ear tucks. Just some styling to bring it away from the face and highlight that beautiful bang area. I'll go ahead and do just a few quick style options for you here so you can get a sense of how this fiber is moving and reacting. We'll see you next time. Taz's Wig Closet at Wig Studio One.